Hello students, this is Usha from GK Jain High Secondary School, Rayapuram. Today we are going to see optics part 1 in 12th standard physics. So the optics mainly of two aspects, one is ray optics, another one is wave optics. First we'll talk about the ray optics. Today we are going to see 12th standard physics optics part 1. Light. In this unit, we are going to learn about two different scientific aspects called ray optics and wave optics. Ray optics deals with light that is represented as a ray traveling in straight line. So they are able to give the various characteristics of light. In wave optics, we study about the phenomena associated with the propagation of light as a wave. Ray optics. Light travels in a straight line in any of the medium. Light may deviate in its path only if it encounters another medium or an obstacle. A ray of light gives information about only the direction of light. The path of the light is called a ray of light, and a bundle of such rays is called a beam of light, which you all have studied in your lower classes. So in this chapter, we are going to explain the phenomena of reflection. The bouncing back of light into the same medium when it is encountered a reflecting surface is called reflection of light. Polished surfaces can reflect light. Mirrors which are silver coated at their back can reflect almost 90% of the light falling on them. Let angle of incidence will be taken as I and the angle of reflection as R, and let N be the normal line which is shown in the diagram. Then, according to the law of reflection, the incident ray, the reflected ray and the normal to the reflecting surface all are coplanar, that is, they all lie in the same plane. The angle of incidence I is equal to the angle of reflection R, I is equal to R. So, the law of reflection is valid at each point for any reflecting surface, whether the surface is plane or curved. Angle of deviation due to reflection. The angle between the incident and the deviated light rays is called angle of deviation of the light ray. So the diagram shows you the incident light is AO, the reflected light is OB, the undeviated light is OC, which is nothing but the continuation of the incident light. The angle between OB and OC is the angle of deviation D. From the geometry, it is written as D is equal to 180 minus of I plus R. As we all know that I is equal to R, that's the rule for the reflection. So when we substitute here, I is equal to R, that is equal to I. So we can write the angle of deviation in reflection at plane surface as D is equal to 180 minus 2I. If the angle of deviation can also be measured in terms of the glancing angle alpha. So the incident ray AO and the reflected plane surface XY has been taken as alpha, then the angle of deviation D is the angle BOC, therefore D is equal to 2 alpha. Next is characteristics of the image formed by plane mirror. The image formed by a plane mirror is virtual, erect and laterally inverted. The size of the image is equal to the size of the object. The image distance far behind the mirror is equal to the object distance in front of it. If an object is placed between two plane mirrors inclined at an angle theta, then the number of images n formed is as given by the formula. If 360 divided by theta is even, then n equal to 360 divided by theta minus 1 for object placed symmetrically or unsymmetrically. If 360 by theta is odd, then n is equal to 360 by theta minus 1 for objects placed symmetrically. If 360 by theta is odd, then n is equal to 360 divided by theta for objects placed unsymmetrically. We are going to see about the real and the virtual images by a plane mirror. The type of image which cannot be formed on the screen but can only be seen with the eyes is called virtual image. The type of image which can be formed on a screen and can also be seen with the eyes is called as real image. Spherical mirrors. So, Spherical mirror is a part cut from a hollow sphere. Spherical mirrors are generally constructed from glass. One surface of the glass is silvered. The reflection takes place at the other polished surface. The reflection takes place at the convex surface, then it is called as convex mirror. And if the reflection takes place at the concave surface, then it is called as concave mirror. So now we are going to see terminologies pertaining to spherical mirrors. First one is center of curvature, which is mentioned here as C. The center of the sphere of which the mirror is a part is called center of curvature of the mirror. Radius of curvature. The radius of the sphere of which the spherical mirror is a part is called as radius of curvature of the mirror. It is mentioned as R. Pole. The middle point of the spherical surface of the mirror or the geometrical center of the mirror is called pole P of the mirror. Principal axis. The line joining the pole and the center of curvature is called the principal axis of the mirror. Focal point. Light rays traveling parallel and close to the principal axis, which incident on a spherical mirror, they converge at a point for concave mirror or appear to diverge from point for convex mirror on the principal axis. This point is called as focal point of the mirror. Focal length. The distance between the pole and the focus is called the focal length. Focal plane. The plane through the focus and perpendicular to the principal axis is called the focal plane of the mirror. So, by using this diagram, we are able to explain these terms. Then we will go into the paraxial rays and marginal rays. The rays traveling very close to the principal axis and make small angles with it are called paraxial rays. The rays traveling far away from the principal axis and fall on the mirror far away from the pole are called as marginal rays. Reflection between F and R. Let me see the diagram. Let C be the center of curvature of the mirror. Consider a ray of light parallel to the principal axis is incident on the mirror at M and passes through the principal focus F after reflection. Then we can say the line CM is normal to the mirror at M. Let I be the angle of incident and the same will be the angle of reflection. If IM is perpendicular from M on the principal axis, then from the geometry, the angle MCP is equal to I and angle MFP is equal to 2I. From right angle triangle MCP and MFP, tan I is equal to PM divided by PC, as we all know that tan is equal to opposite by adjacent, and tan 2I is equal to PM divided by PF. If the angles are small, then tan I can take the value of I. Then I is equal to PM by PC and 2I is equal to PM divided by PF. So for I is equal to PM by PC substituting, we get 2 into PM divided by PC is equal to PM divided by PF. So cancelling PM on both the sides and cross multiplying, will get 2PF is equal to PC. PF is focal length F and PC is the radius of the curvature R. Then we have 2F is equal to R or F is equal to R by 2. This is the relation between F and R. Image formation in spherical mirrors. So this is shown in the diagram that we will explain here. A ray parallel to the principal axis after reflection will pass through or appear to pass through the principal focus. A ray passing through or appear to pass through the principal focus after reflection will travel parallel to the principal axis. A ray passing through the center of curvature retrace its path after reflection as it is a case of normal incidence. A ray falling on the pole will get reflected as per law of reflection, keeping principal axis as the normal. So these are the image conditions given for the image formation in spherical mirrors. Next is Cartesian sign conversion. Here there are 6 points are given. First one, the instant light is taken from left to right. All distance are measured from the pole of the mirror. The distance measured to the right of the pole along the principal axis are taken as positive. The distance measured to the left of the pole along the principal axis are taken as negative. Height measured in the upward direction to the principal axis are taken as positive, which on the other side will be taken as negative. So by using these conditions only, we will start deriving our equation. The first derivation which we are going to see is our mirror equation. So this is the diagram given over here. The mirror equation establishes a relationship between u, object distance, v, the image distance, and f, focal length of the spherical mirror. Let object AB is considered on the principal axis of a concave mirror beyond the center of curvature C. So the image will be formed at the point A dash B dash. Let us consider three parallaxial rays for point B on the object. The first ray BD traveling parallel to principal axis is incident on the concave mirror at D close to the pole P. After reflection, they pass to the principal focus F that we have seen in the condition for the image formation in spherical mirrors. The second parallaxial ray BP incident at the pole P is reflected along PB dash. The third parallaxial ray BC passing through center of curvature C falls normally on the mirror at E is reflected back along the same path. Now the image will consider that as A dash B dash to be the principal axis as the real inverted image of the object AB. As per the law of reflection, the angle of incident angle BPA is equal to the angle of reflection angle B dash PA dash. So the triangle BPA and B dash PA dash are similar. By the rule of similar triangles, A dash B dash divided by AB is equal to PA dash divided by PA. The other set of similar triangles are triangle DPF and triangle B dash A dash F. A dash B dash divided by PD is equal to A dash F divided by PF. As the distance PD is equal to AB, the above equation becomes A dash B dash divided by AB is equal to A dash F divided by PF. Now comparing the two equations, we can write it as PA dash divided by PA is equal to A dash F divided by PF. We have seen from the diagram A dash F can be written as PA dash minus PF. Substituting value in the above equation, we'll get PA dash divided by PA left hand side will be the same, which be equal to PA dash minus PF divided by PF. So they get PA is equal to minus U, PA dash is equal to minus B, and PF is equal to minus F. So as the three distance are negative as per sign conversion, they are measured to the left of the pole. Now the equation become minus V divided by minus U is equal to minus V minus of minus F divided by minus F. On further simplification, we'll get V by U is equal to V minus F divided by F. Making into two terms, V by U is equal to V by F minus 1. Divide either side by V, so we'll get 1 by U is equal to 1 by F minus 1 by V. Taking 1 by V to the other side, you'll get 1 by V plus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. This is called as mirror equation. Lateral magnification in spherical mirrors. The lateral or transverse magnification is defined as the ratio of the height of the image to the height of the object. Let the height of the image, you take it as h dash, and height of the object as h. Then we have magnification m is equal to h dash divided by h. Applying the proper sign conversion, we'll get a dash b dash divided by ab is equal to p a dash divided by pa. So we'll take now a dash b dash is equal to minus h, ab equal to h, p a dash equal to minus v, and pa is equal to minus u. Substituting this value, we'll get minus h dash divided by h is equal to minus v divided by minus u. So left hand side will have a negative, and the right hand side they get cancelled. So we'll have the term m is equal to h dash divided by h, which is equal to minus v by u. By mirror equation, we can further write the magnification as m is equal to h dash by h. which is equal to F minus V by F or F divided by F minus U. Thank you, students. You all have learned about the part 1 of ray optics, where you learned about the reflections and the mirror equation. Thank you. Once again, we'll meet you in the next video.